up, metalheads? Your boy is Don DJ Ramo, and tonight we are interviewing Warpath from San Diego, California. Here is their song, No Mercy! Welcome back. That was No Mercy by Warpath, killing it up live on Skype. What is up, fellas?
What's going on, brother?
What's going on, brother?
Everybody out there.
Dude, I'm so stoked about this interview. We are going full production on this. We are breaking new ground on the Metal Mixtape. This is the first time ever performance on the Metal Mixtape and interview, dude. This is fantastic, dude.
Hell yeah. Glad to be the groundbreakers.
Hell yeah.
Hell yeah, this is Warpath from San Diego, California. So for all the listeners out there that don't know Warpath and the billions listening around the world, why don't you guys introduce yourselves, starting with the drummer?
Dino Suna, play the drums, San Isabel, California.
Go ahead.
All right.
Check. I'm Danny Trujillo, I play bass.
I'm Chance Perez, I sing. And I play guitar.
My name is Harrison Whitecloud, and I play lead guitar, and I do background vocals.
Awesome. I'm so stoked to have you guys back on. I think the last time I interviewed you guys was probably like a year and a half ago. This is round two. You know, and, you know, one thing that I want to mention, that's the first thing I ever noticed about Warpath, was your live show, man. I did not know what to expect of you guys when I saw you guys at Rivera Fest. We saw the booth. We saw the awesome merch. You guys were chill. You guys came in that, like, the, like, school bus thing.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, it was a war wagon before
the first war wagon. Right.
Yeah.
It was the war wagon Mark One.
And I was like, all right, these guys mean business. And I remember having a couple of beers, like drinking, and all of a sudden you guys start ripping the stage and you guys made it sound so damn good. And ever since then, dude, like you guys have been like direct blood with the Oregon metal family, dude. And it's always great to have you guys play.
That's due to the fact that we were received incredibly, incredibly with open arms when we got to Oregon. The people, like you said, didn't know what to expect. They didn't know what was going down, and they saw us, and they said, holy shit, man, we love you guys. So it was real easy for us to pour out everything we had and just give you guys the, you know, who we are. And thank you so much.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, it was definitely a giant, giant hug fest after our set in 2018. And I seem to remember... I don't remember who. I remember you seeing me there, and you're all like, okay. Everybody's all like, holy shit, Warpath's coming over here. And then you dumped the tank of jungle juice down mine and Danny's throats. And that I will never forget immediately.
Oh, yeah, Chance. I remember, what was it? They had, like the Jason big figure there. Remember, like, that big dummy doll?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, Jason remembers us.
Yeah. Jason will never forget us. How's that?
Well, dude, you know, ever since, dude, you know, you guys are royalty back here. Everybody has a lot of respect for you guys. You guys are humble. And one of the things I admire is you guys' work ethic, man. You know, it's definitely, I admire people that work hard, but are also really passionate about it, because you could really tell in a band if they're having fun doing it, or they're just doing it just to do it, you know? And you guys, it just comes out of you like so naturally that it's just, you know, I think that's what people like about you guys the most.
Thank you, man.
Thank you.
I think that makes or breaks a band is how much love and passion you really want to put forth into the band, you know? And like you said, you know, some people just aren't really about it, and that's just something that you can, that's something that all metal fans can smell about a band, is whether or not if they're the real deal about it. And I think Oregon and everybody up there really could sense that we were all really passionate and really loved what we were doing, and that energy going out into the crowd at Rivera Fest for, you know, for the years that we played there, and coming back to us was just that endless cycle of just badass energy that we fed off of each other with. And I think that's what made those Rivera Fest gigs so great, as well as the other gigs that we played in Oregon, you know.
Medford.
Out here in California, we always get a lot of different bands coming in before, you know, COVID hit. But I imagined, you know, it seemed like Oregon was kind of was thirsty for something fresh and something new, you know what I mean? And that... it was an honor for them to consider us such a fresh band that they could feast on. You know what I mean?
Yeah, great.
Yeah, definitely that they could feast on.
So if you're just tuning in, we're talking to Warpath from San Diego, California. We have Harrison, Dean, Chance, and Danny on the bass. What is up, Danny?
That's yeah, they kick him into
right on. So you know what? One of the things we're going to promote with you guys on here is your guys' new single that you're hoping to release in Halloween, is that correct?
Trying to, that's the goal, but we're at the mercy of iTunes, Spotify, all those, all that good stuff. So we'll let you guys know when we're ready to push this out. We're done with the whole production. We're just kind of waiting for to set a date. So we're shooting for the end of October. So keep your eye.
Dude, it's a party over there. I feel, oh, I should have done this in person. So for your new single, you guys recorded a video, is that correct?
Yes, sir. We just got done shooting about a couple weeks ago, and actually probably a few weeks ago now. We got the whole video laid out, and the song is mixed and mastered and ready to go. We're just, like I said, we're just waiting to set a date, and hopefully we can shoot for the end of this month, you know?
Yeah, no, I know everybody's super excited for the new release. It's going to be for your guys' new album, and you guys are having a new face paint. Is that correct?
Yes, it
Hell
is.
Yeah.
We're going to try and make it a thing for every album that we release to at least modify or completely change our makeup. Kind of with the influence of what Slipknot does for their masks, You know, it's you know, not everybody changes their mats completely. However, you know, some people make modifications. I think it's good to implement that sort of change for our image, just so we can keep things new and not fresh. So stagnant.
And the reveal will be during the video that comes out end of this month. So we're excited.
So, Chance, you want to talk a little bit about the song?
So this song is about something really near and dear to my heart. You know, it deals with certain subjects that I'd rather just like not talk about in the interview, if that's all right. But yeah, so I was also thinking, I mean, the cool thing is about this song is that we wrote it like on my birthday.
Yeah.
Right.
And the original song was heavy too.
Well, the funny thing is the original song was heavy, but what did we write them on?
We wrote them on acoustic guitars.
We wrote them on acoustic guitars. So I just think that song is funny, man. And I was just thinking about that, but, yeah, so we wrote it on my birthday, which is the day after Halloween, and I'm just thinking, like, wow, this song really is like a full circle type thing. So
totally, right?
I was just totally just sitting here thinking about that. I'm like, right. Damn, that's really cool.
And for a little spoiler of the song, too, I mean, we did let the cat out of the bag, but it will be an acoustic single that we remade a heavy song out of for our first song off the new album. So we're super-duper excited about it, so we hope you guys really, really, really like it.
Dude, I'm excited, dude. I'm a total sucker for like acoustic and ballads, dude. They're personally my favorite, dude. I'm one of those guys who will buy like those top hits 80s ballads. You know those commercials that come on?
K-Tell.
Oh yeah, dude.
If anybody's old enough to know what the hell
I'd love
that is.
I'd love to tell you a song what it's like, man. It's one of our favorite bands. But if I told you the song and the band, I told you the band, it would give away what. Give away a little bit of the song, so it's probably one of our heaviest influences in our band, and it's really kind of a nod to our idols.
No, I dig it. So one of the questions I wanted to ask you guys that I didn't ask before is where do you get your inspiration for each individual's makeup? Because when I see you guys live, you guys have very different makeup on each one of you guys, like. How'd you guys go about choosing the one for yourself?
Well, mine to start with. So I usually do a white hand. That's what I've done for the first album cycle. And the reason for that is, well, in my family, there was a red hand. The red hand is extended for generations. You go on Google and search Chief White Cloud, you're going to find a painting or a picture of him wearing a red hand on his face. And so for me, that was kind of embracing my heritage, embracing, you know, my ancestors and
was
where
that
I
your
come
great,
from.
Great grandfather?
I'm pretty sure. Yeah, that's correct. So that's why I chose that. And I mean, I chose white just because it shows way better in pictures. And the one time that I did wear a red hand, Danny's girlfriend Jen, she lended me some lipstick to throw onto my hand. We were playing the Whiskey a Go-Go. It was like our first time, I think. Man. Or the second, with the Iron Maiden.
Poor
so,
Harris.
So I slapped that shit on my hand, and I slap it on my face, and it looks cool for the night. I go to wipe it off. That shit is not coming off, dude. I'm like using everything in the book. I'm using makeup wipes, whatever I possibly can. No, it just stayed stuck, and it was awful, but
he looked
since
awfully
then I found
pretty.
New paint.
Yeah, he was good. He was good.
The lipstick stuck. Yeah. Mine. I walked into my walk-in closet and shut the lights off. Tripped on a little peyote. Smoked a little bit of herb. And fucking came out and said, wrapped on a bunch of fucking makeup, came out and said, that looks fucking sick.
You're always smoking.
No, really though, my makeup was, it's just a slight little contortion and variation of what I had before. Kind of the same ideas, a little different, but I'm super fucking stoked on my new makeup, man. I think it looks really hard, man. It looks really tough.
Yeah, that was cool.
And it'll be really in this cool. video. I look badass in it, so... I'm just kidding. Badass. All of our makeups and all of
it
our...
It looks good. It looks
really
good.
Oh, spiel looks really good, man. So it's a new thing for us, man. We're super duper excited, so.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Chance?
So, personally, the first album stuff, it just kind of kept evolving. It first just started with, like, I think two black stripes or something like that, right?
I can't remember.
It was just like that, and then I just kept building off of that. And
the thumbnail didn't
I would just pull up the mirror and just kind of draw on some ore paint and be like, oh, that's pretty cool. I'll go with that. And I just kind of keep with the same theme. And it eventually got to the three black stripes with the dots and then the white stripes. And that was it. And I was just like, I'm vibing with that. nothing as awesome as Harrison's. Harrison's got the coolest reason, in my opinion.
Fuck yeah.
What about you, Dean?
The new nickname of the Chief.
So mine was, I was one of the first ones to wear the page. It was a variation of different cultures that I looked up that were the Plains Indians, you know, out there, and found out that the colors meant different things, colors of the medicine wheel, colors of battle, colors of peace, colors of how you're going to fight, you know. And so I just chose the colors of the medicine wheel and applied it, you know, to my face accordingly. And it came out pretty nice. It was a good, long-lasting face paint, so I wore it well, and kind of just evolved it into a little more yellow and black instead of the full spectrum of the, you know, the medicine wheel colors, which are white, black, yellow, and red. So just a little more tweak here and a little bit, you know, there, and I think a little bit more maybe bead work on stage, a little more leather ties on stage. But, you know, it just kind of, one thing comes to mind is that old Ozzy picture, you know, where he's like this, yep, and he's got a fringe hanging down, dude. That's just the coolest, you know what I mean? So, yeah, a little more of that, a little bit more of all this cool stuff. Like I said, it's our show. Like you said, it's our show that captivates people. So they want to see this, you know, and it's, and that's my inspiration.
Dude, I think that's totally awesome, man. And you guys have a lot of meaning behind it. And I totally love your story, Danny. I totally believe it.
Right?
Spare oral asshole can't see us.
So we were talking about your new single / video, hopefully coming out in Halloween Sleep. And you guys are going to perform that for us right now. Is that correct?
Hell yeah.
Yeah, we are, man.
All right, everybody. This is Warpath from San Diego, California on the Metal Mixtape. And this is their song, Sleep. Hell yeah, and that was Sleep by Warpath Expect, their new single video coming out late October. We'll know soon. Keep track on their Instagram and Facebook. That was absolutely fantastic, guys.
Thank you, brother.
Thanks, man.
Fun stuff,
Dude, I can feel the energy through the phone, man. Yeah. Honestly, I feel like I almost dropped it like 4 times. Right on. Dude, that was absolutely awesome. Well, you know what? For everybody just listening in, we're talking to Warpath from San Diego, California. We got Danny, Chance, Harrison, and Dean. What is up, guys?
Sappening.
Warpath Nation.
Sappening.
You guys know that, right? There's all these bands have their different people, you know. Slipknot has the Maggots. Who else has their fans? Where they
Taylor Swift has Swifties.
Taylor Swift's got Swifties. Dude, Taylor Swift's got more Swifties than Slipknot has Maggots. Because half of the Maggots are Swifties. Secretly.
Warpathians.
Hey, Warpathians.
I told you to stop making fun of me.
We have the Warpath Nation.
Warpath Nation.
The Warpdasses.
Warpath Nation, that's all you guys.
That's our people, man. Thank you so much, Warpath Nation.
You guys keep us going.
Thank you for the support and dying love, man. Seriously. Thank you
so much. We can't do it without an industry
without a strong nation.
There is no us without you.
Yes.
Indeed.
Hell yeah, guys. Hell yeah. So before we get into the ending final performance, we're going to enter the second part of the interview where I ask you 5 questions where you have 30 seconds or less to answer. Warpath and Warpath Nation! And YouTube subscribers and listeners around the world, are you ready, Warpath?
Hell yeah! Bring it on, brother.
All right. All right, starting with you, Dean. Where is the weirdest place you ever took a crap?
I like these new questions.
The weirdest place I ever took a crap. My goodness.
Fuck, man.
Come on, at this point in the interview, it's past 10, so go ahead.
I mean, like, I don't know, the woods, I mean, it's weird out there because you're so used to taking a crap on a toilet. So, over a dead pine tree, you know, sitting there, using it as a, I don't know, it was not nice, it was very weird for me, so yeah. Outdoors, that had to be my answer, outdoors, let's not elaborate on that.
Wasn't sexual either.
What about you, Danny? Where is the weirdest place you ever took a poop?
My girl's outside listening to this interview too. It's for you, babe. The weirdest was my sister-in-law's house, man. I got too buzzed up and it was in my pants outside.
Oh shit. Oh, yeah. I think it's
it was nice, man. It was the weirdest place I have. Every shit was in my pants.
Wow, dude. This interview is groundbreaking already. How about you, Chance?
Oh, Chance is the king.
He's
king shit right here.
But I pretty much always find a toilet. But, I mean, I guess my same answer would also be outdoors, but I was also on the work brick by brick.
that's not
as bad as outdoors.
One of the local venues, but especially here in San Diego.
But the thing was, it wasn't just like outdoors, like it's so peaceful because we live out in San Isabel, and it's actually outdoors. But we were on the work crew, and I had to take a shit then, and my boss was extremely sus, so I didn't feel comfortable for 1 minute. So probably that.
Like the bathroom in like Train Spotting, the worst bathroom in Scotland.
Crawling in the bathroom in the toilet.
Mr. Harrison, how about you, man?
I'm saying any large venue bathroom ever. Or large venue porta potties. Like if you go to Ozfest or some shit in San Bernardino, these are nasty.
You fly his crying on
your ass. That's awesome. That's awesome.
Like rubber hanging over his feet.
What's on your face?
Dude, one time, I think it was at Aftershock. I think it was the last year at Aftershock. I walked into a porta potty. Somebody's phone landed on a big ass turd in one of those porta potties, dude.
It was ringing and shit.
Ringing and shit.
The lady was calling.
And then Harrison went in and dropped the dump on top of it.
Dang.
All right, guys. All right, we're going to go to the second question. This is going to go to Harrison. Harrison, what is one thing you're terrible at?
Oh, fuck. Oh. Sports. I'm so bad at sports, dude. I'm all right, but I fucking suck. That's what comes to mind. First thing.
All right, what about you, Chance?
Nothing.
Not a damn thing. No, I'm just kidding. Anything that has to do with boarding at all. Like, I suck at skateboarding, suck at surfing. I haven't snowboarded yet. So, but I'm probably going to suck at it. that's probably what I can think of for the most part. And public speaking, I'm terrified of it. But yeah. That's it.
Hey, that's weird for a lead singer.
Yeah, it is. Tell me about it. So I'm like, all right, Jen, engage the crowd. It's like, how do I say the right thing?
they're like words. All right, Danny, how about you, man? What's something you're not good at? Oh, yeah. Hey, shots fired.
Oh, these guys, they're mean.
I don't know if I should have asked this one.
I know I make everything. For me, though, I'd probably say just the worst thing for me is, like, I just can't remember, man. I smoke my brain away, so I can't. That's the worst thing I'm at is remembering stuff, man. I can't remember nothing, man. That's why it's cool for me to watch TV shows. I'll watch them, and I'll forget and watch Game of Thrones all over again and be the same thing as the first time.
Yeah, what?
Well, I just can't remember. Yeah.
All right. What about you, Dean? I know, right?
Everybody will agree when I say this. I suck at being on time. I try my damnedest, but I've got a super busy life that I juggle, and there's no excuse. I just really suck at being on time.
It's called Indian time.
Yeah, I'm on Indian time, and Indian time.
Well, if it's Indian time, you're really good at it.
Well, yeah, it's definitely Indian time. Let me explain Indian time. Any Indian time is 30 minutes to 3 hours from the time I told you I was going to be there.
Be where I'm at.
I'm gonna be where I'm at. That's Indian time. So all you people out there that know Indian time, all you powwow people out there that are listening to this up there, Oregon on the West Coast, maybe over in Netherlands in the UK. Indian time, right? It's good. It's good in any culture. We give that to you as natives. We give that to you.
All right, that's awesome. That's awesome. All right, round two of this question. If you had a theme song that you walked out to any place you ever went, what would that theme song be?
Huh? Who is it? Who are you going after?
It's a theme song.
Oh. How about this? We'll go with Chance this time and then go to Harrison.
All right, so my answer... I want to steal Dean so bad.
You can steal it. It's valid. I mean,
I'm not going to.
Okay, cool.
I want you to have it to yourself.
I'll take it. I'll take it.
Because I'm a super beast.
You are. Super beast.
I would walk into just exactly the chorus of Super Beast by Rob Zombie every time I walked in the door. It would annoy the shit out of people, but I ain't going.
Like a wrestler walking into the ring.
Exactly.
Yeah, I'm the one that you wanted. Yeah, I'm the super beast.
That'd be so dope.
That would be dope.
What about you, Harrison? What is your theme song, man?
Yeah. Rock Lobster.
Yeah.
That's awesome. That's awesome. All right, Dean, what is your theme song?
Rock Lobster.
Godzilla. By Blue
Oyster. Godzilla?
Hey, Jungle. That's a good jam right there, man.
Yeah,
it is. I wanted to steal that's it.
Chance wanted to steal it, but thanks, Chance. That was good. I could do that. You could dub it right in perfectly.
Yeah. That is a good theme tune right there.
Yeah.
Godzilla.
All right. What about you, Danny? What's your theme song, brother?
Oh, yeah. I'm waiting for this question. It's the 1982 movie with Arnold Schwarzenegger. It's the soundtrack for Conan the Barbarian, man. That's my theme song.
Yeah.
It's a...
Conan.
Definitely.
Hell it's yeah, my jam.
Hell yeah.
All right. Now we're going to start off with Danny. Danny, if you could play bass in any band in any era, in any time period, what band would that be?
Play bass.
Or any instrument.
Or any instrument for that matter, huh?
Yeah. Regardless, man, I would play with the almighty Led Zeppelin, man. I think that for me would be the ultimate, be able to, with the all-time best band of the world, man. That for me, Led Zeppelin would be it. Yeah.
That's awesome. What about you, Dean?
Dang, we mulled this over last time, and it was, I think, I don't know, man. I'd have to say if we could keep up with them. I hope I'm not stealing anybody's. I'm gonna say the Mighty Pantera.
Fuck, you just stole me.
Stole me.
All right, Harrison, is it the same, or are you gonna get another one?
Okay, yeah, well, since Dean's fucking stole mine.
Sorry, bro.
I'm gonna say Lamb of God, man. That'd be a badass show. Ooh, to hop on the stage with Lamb of God with. You know what I mean?
One song. Harrison, come up, play what would you play?
Redneck.
I played Now You Got Something to Die For.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
That'd be rad. Awesome.
That's awesome. That's awesome. All right, guys, we're gonna have two more questions. All right, we got two more questions left before we get into your last performance. We're going to start with Chance. Chance,
you left out Chance on that last one.
Oh, I thought he said something. All right, Chance.
I'm so sad.
If you could play with any band in any era and
now he's probably going to record an acoustic song or some shit.
He'd be like, Omar left me out of that question and now I want to die.
All right, Chance.
Any era. It would be Korn in their prime. I'd fucking love to be getting up there because I've seen some of those crowds and it's fucking nuts, bro.
99 Woodstock.
Especially some of that early Korn stuff.
Yeah, exactly.
99 Woodstock, they killed it.
Back in the late 90s and early 2000s, man, they were just fucking monsters.
On fire.
Exactly.
Not like they're not monsters now, but...
They still are. They're still super good, but just like the era to match.
Yeah, but yeah, that
the
era.
Band, yeah. It's just... Man, those crowds are just insane.
Some of them shows, I remember back in the day, were just fucking off the fucking chain. I mean, people were just fucking getting crushed in them, you know?
Mm-hmm. For sure.
And they were playing clubs back then, you know what I mean? They weren't like arena... gigs yet, you know, they were still playing club stuff, you know, it was pretty crazy.
Yeah, exactly, it was crazy.
All right, two last questions. I'll start it with you, Chance. What is one band that you think that's underrated?
Seven Dust. Hands down. That's I'll always say that. I'm just like, Seven Dust is like one of the most underrated bands, in my opinion, just because, I mean, Morgan Rose is just such a killer drummer, just alone. You know, and then you got the rest of the band, like, all, like, the guitar riffs, not to mention the vocals. I mean, holy shit, man. Like, it's such, like, a great all-around band that just kind of flew under the radar. Even when they were big, they still flew under the radar compared to, like, you know, the others around that era.
Right. I'll just chime in. I'd have to agree, man. Thinking about that, and I would say probably Seven Dust, too, because till this day, these new albums coming out, I fucking love them, man. They still haven't got that recognition
that they deserve, man. They're so good.
You guys want to know a fun fact? That J.J. French from Twisted Sister produced Seven Dust's big album that started their career off.
Wow.
Oh, nice. You interviewed him, too, right? Interviewed J.J., right?
Yeah, and that's what he told me. He said when he recorded their album, it like made it big.
Nice, so, that's rad.
Wait, hold on, let me stop you right. Didn't you say you interviewed that one death metal guy who was like all weird and creepy and has like torture?
Which one?
Which one?
No, it's like the guy who starts with a G.
Oh, Gah?
Yeah, how is that?
Yeah, his name's Kristen. It was nerve-wracking, dude. My right hand was shaking a little bit, too.
Wow.
Hey, how was it shaking?
Well, the thing is, dude, it's like you go to a guy who's extremely like professional and uses all these like long words, and like he talks very little, but in that little bit that he talks, he fits in so much. So, but yeah,
powerful, huh?
Yeah.
Right on. So, what was the question again?
Oh, okay. Now we're gonna go to Dean. Dean, what is one band that you think is underrated?
I would have to say...
I didn't answer.
Oh, you didn't answer Harrison? Oh, give Harrison, because I don't want to steal his answer.
Oh, no, go for it. Go for it, man.
I'll steal his answer again. Watch.
All right.
I'm going to have to say Ginger.
Ginger?
Yep. Did I steal your answer, Harrison?
No, you didn't.
Okay, good. Yeah, Ginger, very underrated. Tatiana, she is an amazing singer. I don't know if anybody's familiar with Ginger, but what genre is that?
They're pretty big now.
No, I look at the scene. They're very underrated. She doesn't get the props that she deserves.
I agree on that one, dude. Ginger absolutely crushes.
Yeah.
All right, Harris. Then what is one band you think is underrated?
So I know they're really big and they have a really big following, but I don't think it's big enough. I think fucking Gojira is way too overrated, man. They're one of my top favorite bands right now. they're huge right now. However, I mean, I remember Chance and I were at Knotfest together, and after Gojira's set, he mentioned that he's seen somebody, or somebody said something to the effect of, "I just watched Gojira play and it was the worst 40 minutes of my life," something like that. And I was like, wow, that broke my heart to hear those words. So it's like,
nah, I just kicked his ass in the pit later. I found him.
Yeah,
it was pretty cool.
I mean, it breaks my heart that some people feel that way about Gojira, but yeah, that band is amazing, and I feel like they're underrated even though they're really fucking successful right now.
That's awesome. All right, did I ask everybody in?
Yes, sir.
All right, guys. All right. So before we get into your last song that you're going to play, Vermin, tell everybody where they can contact you. Tell them about your new Facebook page and your YouTube page.
Yes, sir.
Go ahead, Dean. Go ahead.
All right. So if everybody didn't know, we had a Facebook page that was called Warpath. I think just Warpath. And it was 6,000 followers strong. We got shut down for no reason. No recourse. Long story short, we made another one, and we're up about 1,100 right now strong, which is great, but we'd like to get it up even more. So if you go to Warpath Official, you can check us out. If you go to warpathnation.com, our website's there. Our first album is up there. There's a bunch of lyric videos there. And Harrison, you want to throw out the rest?
Yeah, along with Facebook, the Facebook is entitled Warpath Official. So is our Instagram. We also have an Instagram, and I mean, we post regularly on there. You know, it's not as big as the Facebook one. However, we are active on there. And our YouTube is not at Warpath Official. It is at Warpath Nation. And look around for is it the headdress design that is the profile picture for that? I can't remember, but
I think so.
If you look up Warpath Nation, all of our old videos from, however long ago, as well as our recent ones, are still on there. And that is the platform that we're going to be doing our live stream performances on. And, I'm heartbroken to see that our original page was Zuckerberged. And, we're not letting that stop our momentum. And we are, we're going to try and maintain the same momentum that we had beforehand. And, YouTube is... you're less at risk of those things happening to you. So for those listening, Warpath Nation on YouTube, make sure to hit the notification bell on there.
Hell yeah.
Yep. I just want to say real quick, we want to throw up our thoughts and prayers to everyone affected by the fires up there in Oregon. I know you were, Omar, you and your family were, and we're doing our best to send whatever we can. I'm going to send you guys some stuff, as you know. We want to just send our thoughts and our prayers and a hope for a better tomorrow up there for everybody along the California and Oregon fire trail that happened over the last few weeks. So to all you out there,
much love, dude. Much love, and we appreciate it. And I know the Warpath Nation across the West Coast is gonna love these next performance, man. So before I let you go, everybody listening right now, and the millions around the world, we're talking to Warpath from San Diego, California. We're talking to Dean Harrison, Chance, and Danny. So for all the Warpath fans, give us some final words about the new album, starting with you, Danny.
All right. Well, like we said before, it's going to be coming out the end of this month. It's an acoustic jam. We worked our asses off on this thing with a video coming out. I really can't really go into more in detail about that, and you know, but keep your eyes open on all our social sites. We'll have it all up there. We're gonna have it on iTunes. We'll have it on Spotify, Deezer, all the major streaming platforms for you. We'll give an announcement probably in the next week or two when that date will be. So keep your eyes and ears open. But yeah, we're super excited. Thank you,
Dean. What is something the fans could expect from the new album?
So we're about 7 to 9 songs. There's a couple in the irons in the fire, and we're about the halfway point of the album that we are definitely not releasing in 2020. Hopefully in the springtime of 2021, if things start to mellow out and we're able to play and support the album, because I really want to be able to be on that stage with other bands and supporting the release of this album. But in the meantime, the writing has not stopped. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8 of those, 7 of those songs are in pre-production right now. And writing has begun on the second half of the album. So we will definitely have a new release for you guys in 2021.
Awesome, dude. Awesome. Harrison, what can the fans expect from the new Warpath album, and how is it different from the last?
What you can expect is certainly more of an organic kind of feel from all of the songs, and how it's different from the first album is the first album we were all younger in some sort of way, and you know, especially myself, you know, I was still really young, I was still in high school, and so I was trying to figure out who I was as a musician, and you know, finding out where everybody sits in Warpath. And you know, nowadays we all have our own certain spots, and we all have, you know, great ideas to throw against the wall. So, you know, the first album, it was like mainly Dean and Chance structuring the songs, and I added solos and stuff. Nowadays, it's all four of us combining our ideas into our thoughts, or all of our thoughts into our songs and into our productions. So, know what you can expect is certainly something more organic and fresh.
Awesome, awesome. Chance, what are some things that the Warpath fans and fans out there could expect from the new album?
I think that they can expect more variety from this album as far as song style. Our first album, you know, we went with like a pretty like traditional, like what would you say, like a metalcore sound. You know what I mean? Like,
something to that
effect. I think it was more straightforward. It's singing. It was more straightforward, I believe.
Well, there's singing and screaming on the first album, right? So you have the spectrum, right? But like the next album is broaden that spectrum.
Yeah, we opened that up a lot, man.
So the softer stuff or the more melodious stuff is more so, and the heavier stuff is even heavier, and everything in between. And I'm really liking how a lot of these songs are turning out, so I can't wait to, you know, get this completed, recorded, and be playing again, and like Dean said, be able to support this album, because, I mean, shit, we're working our asses off like we always do, and I think that's why, you know, we have such a strong Warpath Nation family, because, well, hell, man, we're all in this together, and
right.
I think that, you know, you guys out there believe in somebody that, you know, shit, works their asses off, and shit, we believe in you guys to fucking make it to our shows and fucking support us. And it's a fucking, definitely a beautiful cycle that we have going on.
You guys are in for a treat for this album, man, because we're gonna bring it for you guys. You're gonna really like this album.
Hell yeah.
Hell yeah, dude. Well, hey guys, I want to thank you guys so much for being on the show. I want to thank Harrison,
thank you,
Dean, I want to thank Danny. I want to thank Chance. And they're going to end the show with one more song. This is Vermin by Warpath here on the Metal Mixtape. That was Vermin by Warpath from San Diego, California. That was Harrison D, Chance, and Danny. Guys, thank you so much for being on the show. It was absolutely fantastic. Check out their Facebook, check out their Instagram, check out their YouTube, check out our YouTube, our Facebook, Instagram. Thank you so much, guys. It was so awesome to have you guys. And have a great night.
Thank you, brother. You too.